Hi everyone, and welcome back to my shop. Hymer 3D sensors are fantastic tools for stock setup on the mill. Simply move the probe tip until the dial reads zero and it touched off. But how about an electronic probe? Unfortunately, they're typically too expensive for a home shop. But we can experiment with the idea by attaching a web camera to a mechanical Hymer and using image analysis software on the controller, read the dial face, and send commands to Linux CNC to perform touch-off operations for us automatically. So let's take a look at how this is assembled and how it operates. For the webcam, I'm using a Microsoft Cinema LifeCam. It's a 720p camera, and it's attached to the Hymer probe using a 3D printed part. This is what the software looks like when it started. This is the raw image from the camera. This image shows regions of interest, including the assumed pivot point of the dial. This is the final image with the measurement shown in the corner. This column is associated with the black dial, and this column is associated with the red dial. To read the measurement off of the dial, we first segment the image using color. So we're looking for black features or red features. Then the features are thinned so that the wedge shape of the hands are turned into a single line. Every line in this image is then located and is tested against the pivot point of the dial. Lines that don't intersect with the pivot point are discarded. Those are shown in blue. Lines that do intersect with the pivot point are shown in red. And the final measurement of the dial is shown in green. Now, the red hand is a coarse measurement, while the black hand is a fine measurement. We need the red hand because it tells us the number of times that the black hand has rotated. We can refer to the black hand to get a better measurement of that decimal value. These two hands are then measured, and the values are weighted and merged together to form a final measurement. If the camera has been bumped, you'll see something like this, where there's no measurement being shown, and all the lines that are detected from these thinned images are being discarded. In that case, the assumed pivot point has to be moved over the dial pivot point. I'm using the arrow keys here to do that. And once it's aligned, then the measurements get locked in. This is an example of finding the center of a hole. This is normally done by touching off on one side of the hole, moving along either the X or Y axis to the other side, looking at the measurement, dividing by half, and then moving back that amount. This is a nice example because it shows the computer touching off four times along the X and Y axis unassisted. When the probe makes contact with the edge, we have a definite measurement, and there's no need to continue until the dial reads zero. But that's how the probe is used manually, so that's how I wrote the software. The center along the X axis is now known. The probe moves to that and then begins testing along the Y axis. Here the probe slightly overshot, it corrects itself and continues. The only time the probe has a sense of where it's at is when it's in contact with an edge. When it's moving toward an edge it hasn't contacted before, it doesn't have a sense of how far it needs to go. Now the last edge of the circle has been found, the probe is heading toward the center of the circle, and the G54 offsets are set. On startup, a second or so is needed for the camera to autofocus and to auto white balance. But after that, the system is pretty robust to changes in illumination, with the exception of glare. Glare is a region that of the image where light is being directly reflected into the camera, and anything below the glare is actually being obscured. This is an example of one of the safety features. The probe reads between negative 2 and 2, and if the measured value exceeds positive 1, the current Linux CNC operation is aborted and a warning message is shown. The software also has other safety features, mainly implemented by various ways of reducing noise in the measurements, and also by moving in only steps of the probe diameter at a time. This is another example of a compound operation where the probe is touching off both the X and Y axes on the jaw plate. This was a fun project, and I hope you enjoyed this combination of this stuff. All the source code is on my GitHub page, and if you have any questions about it, just shoot me an email. If you're serious about an electronic probe, be sure to check out ThreadExpress's YouTube page. He's a machinist who has designed an electronic probe with some special features. These links are in the video's description, and I'll add some references for reading mechanical gauges using computer vision to the GitHub page.
Finally, thank you for your interest in my work. It's humbling to think about the total time that others have spent. And I hope to see you again next video.